Stephen Stewart's with me in the studio this morning from PORE. Stephen, good morning.
Hi, Andrew. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure to see you. Look, big morning for you. The start of a drill program at your flagship copper project. Before we get on to that, though, a bit of history. Came to the TSXV last year. Tell us a bit more about the company.
Well, we took the company public by spinning off a few assets from another company called Ore Finders. We have what's called the Man Mine, which is an advanced stage cobalt silver asset in Cobalt, Ontario. It's a former producer. It's a very interesting area for us. We also have a nickel project that we spun off. And we raised a bit of money last year and took the company public. And since then, in December of 2018, we made the flagship acquisition of the Opemiska Copper Mine Complex.
And what was the rationale behind the acquisition, this project? What did you like about it?
Well, the truth is we've been looking at this project for 10 years. Our technical guys, our lead technical VP Exploration, Charles Beaudry, had been working with the vendors of the project for 10 years and assisting them in digitizing the historical work that's been done. So we've had our eye on it. When we took PORE public and we spun off those existing assets and raised the money, it really was us creating a vehicle to acquire this Opemiska asset. So it's a 10-year story in the making.
And you've got a wealth of historical data on the project?
That's true. It's got an abundance of digital data historical data, plans, sections, papers, etc., that we've since digitized. It was Falcon Bridge's flagship copper mine for 40 years. So it operated from the 50s up until the 90s. Falcon Bridge were excellent operators. They kept good records. There's literally garages full of this historical data. Part of the challenge, of course, is taking that paper data, making it digital, and that's something that we've been doing over the past 8 months.
What kind of grades have we seen here?
Well, when it was operated by Falcon Bridge, they took 1.4 billion pounds of copper at an average grade of 2.4% with about a half a gram gold. So very, very high grade, but that was an underground context. We're taking this and looking at it, in a totally different light. Different style of mining, different economics, of course. This is an underground, we're turning it into an open pit mine. The mineralization is very near surface. We've got fantastic intersections of the high grade veins, which they were mining during the Falcon Bridge area, but we're looking at it not only in the open pit context, but we see disseminated material. So outside of these very rich, and we see up to 20-30% copper equivalent in these veins, the wall rock carries. And we're seeing, 1, 2, and 3% in some cases in the wall rock. And that's really our focus of the drill program that we're starting this morning, in fact, is all about delineating the disseminated lower grade resource that Falcon Bridge either didn't pay attention to or certainly wasn't economic in the context of an underground mine. And when copper was 50 or 60 cents, it didn't make sense, but now it does.
And how extensive will this program be?
We're doing 3,500 meters. As I said, the drilling starts today. It's going to take us 45 to 60 days to complete it. From there, we'll take all of that new data and we'll bolt it on to the existing model that we have been discussed earlier about the digitization. And from there, we'll come out with the project's maiden 43-101 resource. It will be pit constrained, meaning we're just going to be looking at an open pit scenario. And that's probably to about 250 to 300 meters within a pit, but there's still outside of that, which will be a phase two, there's a lot more at depth.
Right. And this is all part of a multi-year earn-in.
It is.
Process.
So in December, we signed the agreement with the vendor who we've known for a long time. It's a four-year earn-in option agreement we will be earning 100%. I think the terms are quite favorable. It's, as I said, it's over 4 years, so it gives us a long time to exercise this option. The terms are we spend $3 million in the ground, which, we're certainly making headway into that $3 million in the ground, and then we pay $1.5 million in cash to the vendors, but that is heavily weighted towards the end. When we signed the deal, we approached the vendor and we said, look, this market's very tough. If we're going to do an earn-in agreement here, we need time and flexibility, which provides optionality. So the thought is, as we drill this project out, bring it into the 43-101 regime, if you will, and establish not only a resource, which we plan on doing this year in the Q3, but the economics around it, put a PEA on it, we think the market's really going to take note. We've done a lot of research, not just on this project, but other comparables out there. And quite frankly, we just don't see any other copper project that we can compare it to, certainly not in Canada, even in the U.S. that has this grade, the scale, the tons, and the access to infrastructure.
Well, tell me a bit more about that. Where is the project and what is the infrastructure like around it?
The project's located, it's in the heart of Quebec. It's in just by a town called Chapay, which is in the Chibougamau Copper District. The Chibougamau Copper District's been mined for, 50 plus years, more than that, in fact. In terms of infrastructure, because this was Falconbridge's flagship copper mine, for over 40 years, the infrastructure is already in place. We've got a CN rail spur right to the property. We have a paved highway running through the property, power's on site. There is an airport 15 kilometers away, and there's other resources all around us as well, so potentially there's an opportunity for further consolidation down the road. However, for now, we're just exclusively focused on the Opemiska. So getting back to our objectives, it's really about delineating that economic ore body, and once we do that, the infrastructure's in place, which for a base metal project, I think that's exceptionally rare.
Give us a couple of words, if you would, on your other project, the Man Mine.
Sure.
How far advanced is this?
It's fairly advanced in the sense that it's been drilled out substantially. It's got multiple shafts, ramps, etc. It's flooded. We could go down and dewater and relatively near term be right in front of the mineralization. It's got exceptional grades. It's got intersections of up to 5,000 grams per meter on the silver. It's got exceptional cobalt grades. But in terms of focus, that's not where we are focused on. It's an asset, it has value, but 100% of our time, resources is dedicated to the Opemiska. What I think is gonna happen in the district of the Man Mine, it's sort of a consolidation play. There are larger companies there that are exclusively focused on that area. I expect a roll-up to happen, and when that does occur, I expect more than likely us to vend off the Man project to another company.
I suppose, as the name suggests, power ore with copper cobalt assets. You're very much leaning towards the battery metals space.
Certainly. We're big believers in the battery metals aspect, more particularly the electric vehicles. That has the potential to really revolutionize the world. Not to be sort of broad strokes about it, but it's copper, it's nickel, it's cobalt. Those are the areas that the power ore is really geared towards.
Coming to the market, as you said at the start, middle of last year, is the market aware of yourselves and what you're up to, do you feel?
To some degree, yes. I think we had a baked-in following because it was a spin-off from Ore Finders, which is another gold-focused company that we operate. So everybody who followed Ore Finders, which has a fairly substantial following, was at least made aware of Power Ore because they actually became shareholders of Power Ore. But outside of that, copper is certainly a different market. So it's, there are your gold-focused people who don't necessarily focus on copper. So there has been, I guess, a process in terms of educating people. What does 1% copper mean relative to 1 gram gold? How does that stack up? So there's definitely a learning curve from the people who followed us and our team. But I think you look at our market cap, I guess you could say people don't know who we are. And so that's, part of this exercise is spreading the word. I certainly think a drill program, which we're in the midst of, is going to start to get attention when we come out with some intersections. We're certainly very hopeful we'll be able to replicate and even improve upon some of the historical drill holes that are, we've published and put on our website, which are exceptional. So drill holes get attention, so we'll leave it at that, and I think we'll start to see more eyes on our story soon.
Well, that's what I was, that leads me on to sort of quite a nice place to wrap this up. No shortage of news, by the sounds of it, in the coming months as the drill program advances, results, and the maiden resource in Q3, ideally.
Absolutely. Drill results first, and we'll have a series of them coming out. We'll build on that, build some excitement, which, hopefully the market, wants to see. I think the market's sort of been depressed, but, maybe we'll buck the trend with some great results. Then you're absolutely right. We'll come out with the resource, define the geology, and then we'll move on to the economics.
Good to see you. Stephen, thanks for your time.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.